That's my sister. Very good thought. I can keep my head the same as my brother. I'm as tall as me.
Angels bow before him, heaven and earth adore him.
good as you can, listen, you hear it. Poor people. You know, I found this is a Baptist church, right? Isn't it? Isn't it a Baptist church? Is it a Southern Baptist church?
Yes.
Southern Baptists do not sing loud sitting down. So let's all stand. Open up your mouth. You got the word. I even got the word right there. I just realized back on that wall. I like that. Sing it now.
Oh, I like it.
I will declare your name to my brethren. In the midst of the assembly, I will praise you. Psalm 22, going down to verse 25, my praise shall be of you in the great assembly. I will pay my vows before those who fear him. The poor shall eat and be satisfied. Those who seek him will praise the Lord. Let your heart live forever. All the ends of the world shall remember and turn to the Lord. All the families of the nations shall worship before you. For the kingdom is the Lord's, and he rules over the nations. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Lord, we come to you this morning so grateful for your goodness to us. Lord, we are so unworthy to even praise you, but by your grace you make it possible. Lord, I thank you that you desire our praise and you inhabit our praise. So we praise you this morning. Thank you for everyone that's here. Lord, I thank you for missions around the world. Thank you for people like Paul and Janet Rohde that have sacrificed so much of their lives to share the gospel to people in other parts of our world. Thank you for them. I pray, Father, that you'll help us today as we not only reminisce about old times, but Lord, I thank you that we also have an opportunity to think about missions this morning. We ask all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. I am so glad to see you in our service this morning. I'm not going to introduce all of you folks, but I want to just, for those that maybe are here and don't realize this, my mom was there, but she wasn't a pastor, was pastor of Unity Baptist Church on the north side of Houston in the Aldine area. from 54 to 63, roughly. And I called Brother Paul Rohde to come. He had been in that church, a young child in that church, and asked him to come and speak today on our International Mission Day, which is what this is. And we kind of thought about it, and we said, you know, there's a bunch of other people in the greater Houston area that might like to come and hear him as well. So you Second Baptist folks, that's what these most of these people are. People from Unity Baptist Church, days gone by. Mission-minded church. We had Sunbeams and RAs and GAs, and we grew up learning about missions. And the Lord really blessed us with a mission-minded church. And also, we are the children of WMU ladies and brotherhood men that are here today. I want to introduce just a handful of people. I'm going to introduce Brother Paul and Janet a little bit later on at the end of this, but I want to introduce Wayne St. John. Wayne, will you either stand or raise? You can stand. Yeah. He's one, really the one that had the vision for inviting the Unity Baptist Church folks. Most of us got a message from Wayne on email or phone call or something to invite us to come. I want to introduce my wife, Debbie, right here. You'll stand. For the benefit of the Unity people who don't know who my wife is, this is Debbie Thorne. She's from Harlingen, Texas. We've been married. We're in our 40th year of marriage already. Then my brother Danny, right here, Danny Thornton, and his wife Peggy, and their granddaughter Cindy, all these Thorntons. Danny's a missionary also in Latin American countries, and so glad to have Danny here. My sister Ruth Ann, right here, lives in Philadelphia, and her friend Barbara Mitchell came with her. And Ruth Ann lives in fact, Dr. Ruth Thornton, she lives in Philadelphia and teaches in medical school, and she'll be playing the flute in a moment during the offertory. And she'll be accompanied by Donald Graham, right here. Donald was the pianist in that Unity Baptist Church, still plays, obviously still plays today. Geneva, right here somewhere, is his wife, and appreciate y'all coming. They live in Zavala, Texas, right? I'm down in Zavala, Texas. And then Treva McCracken. I don't know them as well. Brother Delmer, right here, and Treva, thank you for playing the organ for us. Brother Delmer is the pastor of Friendship Baptist Church, and I think has a Caldwell address on Highway 36. Some of y'all have been up in that area. And another Unity Baptist Church couple. And then Charles Cates. Some of y'all know him as Ed, or Edward. But Charles was also in that church, and he leads the music at Oak Forest Baptist Church on the north side of Houston. Came down to help us out today. It's hard for a minister of music to get away around Christmas time, but appreciate y'all coming. And Linda. That's right. My grandparents were in that church. And Jan Slaughter's sister is one of the church secretaries. Jan is up here. Our church secretary is her sister's his church secretary. Where's Linda? Okay, Linda, his wife right here. So thank y'all for coming. Brother Paul Rohde, he and Janet have been in Guyana. Guyana, is that close enough? Okay, that's down in South America. He'll tell us more details about that. But remember, as a young man, Paul and his family being in our church, and the Lord just blessed us so tremendously with sending you on your mission field. We've been keeping up with you for all these years. Looking forward to you speaking to us and y'all sharing with us about what the Lord's doing. I think they're on the verge of retirement, about ready to retire. Okay. We're going to have dinner on the grounds at the close of the service. If you came today and maybe didn't know about that, you're welcome to join us. If you didn't bring any food, don't worry. We have plenty of food for everybody. And so I hope you'll stay and just we'll have a little bit of mission emphasis down there as well. Then we'll just fellowship together for as long as we want to. There will not be any evening service tonight, so we will not have anything because of the activities this morning and at noon. We want to greet one another for a few moments, and in our church, it takes quite a long time. I'm kind of thinking maybe what we'll do this morning is just maybe greet the ones kind of around you, and don't make a point to speak to everyone that's here. Let's stand together and we'll sing the fact of God.